y'all, welcome to What Chelsea Eats. Thank you so much for joining me. In this video, I'm going to be sharing with you easy meals to help you shrink fibroids naturally. I will be sure to add all the ingredients and the links to any products that I use in this video down in the description box below. If you're new here, welcome. I am so glad you landed on my channel. My name is Chelsea Knutson. I'm a certified holistic health coach and the creator of the 90-Day Walk to Freedom from Fibroids group coaching program, where I help women shrink fibroids naturally using food as medicine. There is a link down in the description box where you can learn more if you're interested. Also, be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you never miss an episode. So the first thing I'm gonna do is start my quinoa. I'm gonna be using quinoa for two dishes, and all I'm doing is cooking 1 cup of quinoa for 2 servings. If you wanna know how to make the perfect quinoa, I have a video for it. I will link it down below in the description box and up in the cards at the top of the screen. So let us get started on our first meal, and that is a blood-building green smoothie. I've got 2 cups of frozen cherries and 2 frozen bananas. Then I have 3 different products that I'm adding to this smoothie. The links to these products are down in the description box, but it is spirulina, barley grass juice powder, and dragon fruit powder. Now it's time for our greens. This is a 50-50 mix. This is mixed baby lettuces and baby spinach. The exact recipe is down in the description box. Next, you can add your liquid. You can put water, almond milk, hemp seed milk, pumpkin seed milk, whatever kind of milk you like. This right here is almond milk. You can make it yourself, or you can buy a very clean brand from the grocery store. Now let's get this smoothie going. I'm using my new Vitamix. This is the Ascent 3500. I love it. So we're gonna add these greens to the blender, and I'm gonna push them down into the blade so I can get everything into the blender. Now this smoothie is going to be for 2 servings. So if you only wanna make 1 smoothie, make sure you pay attention to the recipe and half the recipe when you make it. So this is about 4 packed cups of mixed greens, 50-50 blend, spinach and baby lettuces. Next, I'm adding the dragon fruit powder, the spirulina, and the barley grass juice powder to the blender. Now I'm adding the frozen cherries and the bananas to the blender, and you don't have to use frozen. You can use fresh if you'd like. And lastly, we're going to add our 4 cups of almond milk. And then we're gonna put the lid on and blend the ingredients until they are smooth to my liking. And if you have like a whole lot of frozen fruit in here, you might have to do it more than 1 cycle, but this smoothie blended perfectly in, I think it's like 50 seconds that it blends. This ended up being a very green smoothie, but it didn't taste green. It tastes delicious. So I advise you to make this smoothie as soon as possible and drink it as often as possible, because if you have low iron, or if your hair's falling out, or if you're anemic, it's gonna help you to recover. So drink it, drink it, drink it. Now it is time to check on that quinoa, and it's cooked perfectly. You bring it to a boil and then you let it simmer for 15 minutes. It's perfect, 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 nice and fluffy. I'm going to be adding this to my salad and to a vegetable dish that I'm going to show you how to make. Okay, so now it's time for me to show you how to make this very hearty salad. When you eat the salad, you will be full. I sent my husband to the grocery store this morning to get me a few things, and one of the things he got was this head of red leaf lettuce, and they apparently had small ones there because I could eat that by myself. So I decided to add some mixed greens, to like some spring mix to this, because the head of red leaf was just not going to be enough for this salad, and this salad is being made for two people. So I'm cutting the salad greens really coarsely, not anything really small. Most of the time you guys see me cut my salad greens small. I didn't want it really small. So I'm just cutting it, and I'm gonna add it to the salad spinner so that I can wash the lettuce before I add it to my salad bowl. So I have washed the lettuce, and I'm gonna put the lid on the salad spinner and spin all the excess water off of the lettuce so that it's dry and I can add it to my salad bowl. Now I'm gonna add some spring mix so that I can make this enough salad for both me and my husband. So you see those big handfuls I'm using to put in the bowl? I'm also gonna be putting a lot of other things in it to make it nice and filling. So what I'm doing here is just mixing the spring mix with the red leaf lettuce so the lettuce is distributed throughout the bowl effectively. Isn't it pretty? I just love the way the lettuce looks. And if you eat salad like this, I know some of you are like, more salad, Chelsea? Come on, you're kidding me. I don't want to eat salad. But if you want to heal, you're going to eat these greens. Like, take these greens like they are medicine, because they are the medicine foods of God, and they are going to help you to heal. Get that through your head. The greens are going to help you heal. And if you cannot eat a salad, shove it in the blender with some fruit so it will mask the taste of the greens. But what you'll find is the more you eat the greens, the more you will crave the greens, and it won't be a problem after a while. Now I am going to add some quinoa to this salad to make it a little more hearty. And this is what you can do. Like, some people are saying, I don't feel full when I eat the salad. First of all, it's probably you're not eating a big enough salad. But you can add things like quinoa to the salad to make it feel a little more filling. Now, there are some situations where women shouldn't eat quinoa. And usually that is like if you're bleeding really heavy and you've been eating the quinoa and things haven't shifted for you after a few months, then you probably have to stay away from the quinoa for a little while so that your body can adjust. Now I'm going to cut my tomatoes into these little wedges. You can cut your tomatoes however you want. You can slice them, you can chop them, you can do whatever it is that you want. Personally, I like to position my tomatoes on my salad so that it looks nice and pretty. But really, all you have to do is just dump the tomatoes on the salad bowl. It doesn't have to look pretty. But sometimes they say we eat with our eyes, so if it looks pretty, you might be more inclined to eat it. If you notice, I am using very simple ingredients for this recipe. I only do simple recipes. I don't do complicated recipes because I don't have time to do complicated recipes. But what I did here is I peeled the skin off of this cucumber because it had, even though it was organic cucumber, still felt a little waxy even though I washed it. So I just peeled that skin off, and then I'm chopping it and I'm gonna add it to my salad. Now I am going to add some apricots. Now, if you don't like apricots, or you're watching this video and apricots are not in season, well, just use another fruit that you do like. I love apricots, and I especially love eating them in the summer because they're nice and sweet. So I'm gonna chop these up and I'm going to add them all over my salad. Now I'm gonna add some red onion. If you want to use onion, use whatever kind of onion you like. I just happen to prefer red onions on top of my salad versus the yellow or the white onion. I think it just tastes better. So I'm gonna chop this up really small because I don't like big pieces of onion in my salad. Now, a good way to make salads taste really good is by seasoning them. I'm using Herb Fest by Frontier Brand. I'm sprinkling it all over this salad. Next, I'm sprinkling some onion flakes on top of this salad. This is the Kirkland brand from Costco. I love the way it makes salads taste because it gives the salad a bit of a crunch. Next, I'm adding some black sesame seeds. I'm just gonna put a sprinkle on, nothing major. It's just gonna add a little bit of flavor. See how I'm just sprinkling just some on top? That's it, that's all it's gonna get. Now it's time to make the dressing. This dressing is called lemon basil vinaigrette. It's one of the dressings that is in my 90-day program. And the reason I'm making it is because one of the ladies in the group just has fallen in love with it. And I was like, let me revisit this recipe because I don't even know if I remember what it tastes like. But it's very easy to make. I'm using my TriBest personal blender here to make it. I absolutely love using this blender to make things like salad dressings. But it just has lemon juice, balsamic vinegar, water, hemp seeds. Now you can use almonds as well, hemp seeds or almonds, raisins. Fresh basil is what the recipe calls for, but you can use dry basil if you would like. Dijon mustard, and if you use salt to taste, you can put some pepper in there if you'd like. And you can also add a kick to it, like some cayenne pepper or some chipotle pepper to give it a kick. But I absolutely love this dressing. It came out great. Okay, sometimes you need something warm. So here's my recipe. I've got some cannellini beans, organic, BPA-free container. Some parsley, fresh parsley, and some quinoa. Then we've got some carrots, mushrooms, a tomato, and some yellow onion. I'll show the herbs and spices in a second, but I just want to share with you. You can use any kind of green you want. This is curly kale. I got two large handfuls of curly kale that I'm going to add to the pot at the end of the cooking. So I add a little bit of water to this pot, getting it heated up because you know I don't use oil when I cook. You could use vegetable broth if you want, you can use water, really whatever kind of healthy liquid that you want. So what I'm doing is adding the onions and the carrots to the pot, and I'm gonna let those steam down a little bit. And as that's steaming down, all you do is you just move it in the pan, just like if you were sauteing something with oil. I let that cook for like a minute, 30 seconds to a minute, and then I started adding the other vegetables that were in the pan, in the bowl, because those are softer, don't take as long to heat up. And you guys know, I don't like my food to be overcooked. Adding some more water so that the food in the pan does not stick. You just stir it around. Keep it moving so all sides of the food can cook evenly. So next I'm gonna add my parsley and my cooked quinoa to the pan. Just gonna add it to the pan and then just stir it in. Let it cook together. Let all the flavors meld together from the vegetables. Now I've got my spices, onion powder, chipotle, garlic powder, and cumin. And you just stir it until it's well combined. Make sure that all of the vegetables in the pan are completely covered with the seasonings, and then you just add your cannellini beans. And you stir it in. That's all you do. This is a simple, easy meal. Was not hard to make, and you just heat it through. It takes probably 7 minutes to make this whole dish. Now the last thing we're gonna do is stir in the spinach. And we're just gonna pile that spinach in the pot. The fire's still on underneath the pan, still cooking. But you can, at this point, just turn the fire off of your pot, and what'll happen is the heat from the dish is going to wilt down the kale. And if you're not a fan of kale, you can use spinach, you can use arugula, you can use whatever, mustard greens, turnip greens, collard greens, you can use whatever greens you want. But the key is we don't want to be eating too many beans. So the key is to, if you want to eat beans, just fill the pan with lots of vegetables and let the beans be the condiment. So it took about 30 seconds for the greens to kind of wilt down in the pan. Now it's ready to serve. Look at that. Doesn't that look delicious? I'm ready to eat it. I've already eaten it, but I'm ready to eat it. This is really a good, simple dish. And you can double the recipe and have it for a few days. There you have it, ladies. We have the vegetable bean dip, this beautiful blood-building smoothie, this beautiful hearty salad, and this delicious basil lemon vinaigrette dressing. It is so good. I can't say enough about it. So, but if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with a friend, and don't forget to subscribe. Until next time, y'all, take care.